Hello and welcome to In Affinity. We're going to look at the Selective Colour tool, which is very helpful in changing colours, but in a very subtle way. Before we get into the how it works with photographs, which we'll do in a later video, we're going to look at just what's happening at the red, green and blue level, because you need to understand that to use it effectively. So let's go Adjustments and Selective Colour. And we'll put it over here, where you can see all of this and see what happens. Notice here we've got reds here. If I click on this, we've got yellows, greens, cyans, blues and magentas, so the primary and secondary colours. And then we've got whites, neutrals and blacks. So we're going to look first of all at the colours. Notice also this little checkbox over here, which is relative. Turn it off, you get absolute. This is just a, if you like, an amplifier. Normally you get very subtle, small changes with its relative. Click that and the effects are bigger and more pronounced. So let's look at what happens. Just try stuff. Turn this up and down. What can we see? What's changing on this picture? Well, it's only on the red layer and is noticeably in the black there and a bit of grey. Have a look again. Watch that bear. See? Look at that changing. So what's effectively saying is, and this is an important thing about selective colour, not only where there is red, but where red is dominant. Because in white, for example, there's plenty of red in white and green and blue. But only in this top layer here are you going to get this effect. And what you're doing, so let's take the info panel, which I've got down here, and put it up here so we can see it. If you haven't got the info panel, you can go to View and Studio and turn it on here. So we'll drag that little circle up into the middle of that to see what's there. So we've got red and very little green and blue on that. So if I turn this control here, the cyan, the only thing that's changing is red. This is here. Although it says cyan, it's actually a red control because it's in reverse. And it's not changing the cyan down here because reds are selected here. So as I move this down here, see the red is going up here. Now go the other way, notice the way red goes down. So in other words, where I've only got red here, when I'm making it this way, red's going up, it's making the red brighter. And if I turn it this way, it's making the red darker and going closer to black. If I take the next one, look at what happens. Look, it's now going to yellow if I turn go that way, and not much happening if I go this way, because this is a green control, right? The opposite of magenta is green, think of it as RGB. If I go this way, I am turning down magenta, which is turning up green, so you're getting more green in here. So now, see, you've got green and red the same, which is why you've got yellow, because red and green make yellow. If I turn this back down here, only green is changing. Notice only green changing here. When I get to the middle, it's zero. So I can't go down anymore. So if I go that way, nothing is going to happen. And guess what? This is going to be similar with yellow. So I turn this down here. I'm in fact turning up blue. So I got blue and red making magenta. And the blue changes here, goes it down till it gets to nothing in the middle. And then if you keep going this way, nothing else happens. And what about black? If I turn this way, notice everything is fading down altogether now because I'm making this more white. And look at what's happening here. Watch the info panel as I turn this down here. See, all three colours are changing. That's what black does. It changes all three colours and that way it makes it lighter, moves towards white. And I move to the right. It's going to make it go down as far as it's going to go, but it's kind of pushed down the green and blue. It can't move this anymore, so it's not going to just push that to black. Yeah, it needs to work with the other colours. If I take off relative, let's see what happens here. Ah, now it's going down. Yeah, so now that's going down all the way to black there. So that's a notice a difference there. When it's relative, it takes note of what's there already. Okay, so that's pretty much how this works. I'm not going to go into more stuff here, but I will go into more things in detail in later ones. But the same effect happens everywhere. We could change any of these, selecting the colors here. The bottom line is, it says, where is the color here dominant? Then I can change the red, green, and blue, which are the opposites of cyan, magenta, and yellow. Think of these as backwards RGB controls, or all of them together going towards white or not. Relative is whether you have a small effect or a significant effect. That's enough for now. Thank you very much for watching.